Students, today I want to discuss about the chapter 6 of CBSE board, class 10, science. The title of chapter is life processes. So first of all, I want to discuss that what is life. The matter can be distinguished between living and non-living on the basis of certain characters. The basic unit of life is cell. The living things are capable of maintaining their bodies themselves by several life processes. Some organisms are made up of one cell known as unicellular, while other those who are made up of more than one cell is known as multicellular organism. The process which maintain and repair the bodies of living beings for functioning are called life processes. Just you can see here about the plant cell as well as animal cell. So there are some of the differences. So again I want to focus my views on different life processes. So they are as nutrition, transportation, metabolism, respiration, reproduction and excretion. So today I want to focus deeply regarding the nutrition, and that is one of the very important and first life process. All living beings need energy to perform their task. For that, they need food. The source of this energy is food, which provides nutrients for the body development and energy for the work. Some organisms like green plants use simple food material obtained from inorganic sources in the form of carbon dioxide and water. They are known as autotrophs. The other organisms like animal and fungi utilize complex substances which have been broken down into simpler ones by enzyme. Such organisms are known as heterotrophs. Heterotroph survival depends directly or indirectly on autotrophs because they are unable to perform their food their own. So regarding nutrition, so I want to discuss about the types of nutrition. So there are two types of nutrition, again that is autotrophs and heterotrophs. Auto means cell and trophic means nutrition. So autotrophs make their food by the process called photosynthesis. It is the process by which green plants, which is also known as autotrophs, take carbon dioxide and water, which is converted to carbohydrate in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Carbohydrates are utilized for providing energy to the plant. Therefore, we can summarize it by the equation CO2 plus H2O in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight has been converted into C6H12O6, that is sugar, or you can say that is carbohydrate, and oxygen is released in the gaseous form. So these carbohydrates, which are not used immediately, it is stored in the form of starch, which serves as internal energy reserve to be used as and when required by the plants. During photosynthesis, there are different steps. So I want to highlight the first step, that is absorption of light energy by the chlorophyll, which are only pertaining to the green plants area. The second step, that is conversion of light energy to chemical energy, and this chemical energy is splitting the water molecule into hydrogen ion and oxygen. This hydrogen ion is going to reduce in third process of the carbon dioxide and convert it into the carbohydrates. One thing I want to give very important for you, that while larval plants prepare their food during the day time, however, the desert plant take carbon dioxide at the night and prepare an intermediate which is acted upon by the energy absorbed by the chlorophyll during the daytime. Why it is so? You know that desert plant is growing in desert or hot climate, and they don't have much of the rains, so therefore you can say that it is scarcity of water. Wherever stomatal aperture which are open during the daytime, so what will be there? There will be great loss of water, and if there will be great loss of water in desert plant, though they don't have much of the water ambient, therefore they will lose their life. Therefore, it is very important that stomata which has been open during the night, and CO2 will be absorbed by the gaseous exchange and utilize that CO2 during the daytime, and photosynthesis process will be occurred. Now, this is the photograph how there is opening and closing of the stomata, which is very important for the gaseous exchange, and that carbon dioxide, which is very important for the photosynthesis. Stomata open on the surface of leaves, massive amount of gaseous exchange take place in the leaves through the pores of the stomatal aperture. The gaseous exchange will be utilized by the process of photosynthesis. The opening and closing of pores is the function of guard cell, and just you see in the picture the guard cell swell up when water comes flow into them, causing the stomatal pores to open. Similarly, the pores close if the guard cell will see. Water is used in photosynthesis, is taken up from the soil by the root of terrestrial plant. The other material like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and magnesium are taken up by the soil. Nitrogen is taken up in the form of inorganic nitrates or nitrites or organic compounds. This has been prepared by the material from the atmospheric nitrogen. Now, we can also focus about the heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophy is different, and totally, you know that that is a nutrition. The animals and fungi lack the ability to prepare their own food, and in my previous slide, already I have focused that the plant or any life which are having the chlorophyll or green chlorophyll only have the ability to trap the sunlight, and this is the first requirement of the autotroph. But these animals and fungi, they don't have such kind of property, and therefore they always depend on the plants for their food. The heterotroph ingests the food from various sources and use it for their purpose. Therefore, again we can focus it. So this is the heterotroph, and they are green plants and doing photosynthesis, preparing the organic molecules by the process of photosynthesis, and This is a picture which has been focusing about the heterotrophy. And heterotroph, they are ingesting the organic food material which has been prepared by autotroph and depending for their life. So this is all about the nutrition.